Welcome to the Sarah and George Choy Property Podcast, the show that helps you become financially free so you can spend time with your family, traveling and pursuing your passions. Woo-hoo. Today we're going to talk about how to make £1,000 fast.
Yeah, and it doesn't involve robbing a bank.
Nope.
So we don't advocate that kind of thing. No. Okay, we're actually going to talk about kind of stuff in your house, clutter, things you have around. Stuff is stressful. You know, the more stuff you have in your house, the more your brain's looking around, registering all the stuff, and oh God, I got to put that away, and oh, I really need to tidy that up, and I wish the kids hadn't left that out. And it can really stress your brain. It kind of gives you decision fatigue, and you need that decision-making capability to make important decisions, not just like where to put your shoes. So by having less shoes, you'll have less problems with deciding those kind of things. I don't really care about shoes.
I mean, we met someone recently who told us that she just went out and bought a giant wardrobe to put all the clothes that she doesn't wear.
Yeah. It's like, but at least she had that realization that she needed to go through her stuff. Definitely. So hooray, she was making progress. Another thing that people don't kind of realize is that stuff takes up space. If you've got a lot of stuff, you need a whole spare room to put your stuff in. Or, you know, if you've got a spare room, it ends up full of stuff, even if you don't end up doing it deliberately. Or your garage ends up full of stuff, or your loft ends up full of stuff. And if you're looking to move, you need to buy a house that's big enough for you and all your stuff. So what we're advocating is getting rid of some stuff. So we thought we'd have a stab, didn't
yes,
we?
Yeah.
This is something that we actually do. We've moved house a few times in the last couple of years. If you've been watching us, you've seen that. And that's a really good time to declutter and get rid of your stuff. It's when you move. Because obviously, the less stuff you have, the less cost the removers have, and then the smaller house you need. So we've been doing that. But even if you're not moving, it's quite a good idea to put it as a recurring in your diary, kind of every 6 months or at least once a year, you know, the spring clean, but it can be any time.
We like to do it before birthdays and Christmas with the kids' toys.
Yeah, that works really well. Before birthdays and Christmas, we either do it properly and say, oh, you need to get rid of some of your toys because you're getting new toys, or we do it stealthily when they're not there. Will take some of their stuff out of their room.
Let's hope they're not watching
this one. They don't tend to watch the vlog. So we'll take things that they just don't play with away secretly, and then they've got more room for more stuff. So that way, at least you've got a one in, one out. So at least you're not accumulating stuff.
Yeah.
And you can give it away if it's not much good to anybody, or you can sell it. Leads on to George.
Yes, exactly. So I just thought I'd share with you some of the things we sold, because then you might think, oh, wait a minute, I've got some of that. I could do that. Or I didn't know you could sell it for that much. And some of the things maybe that you thought had no value.
Yeah.
That you were just going to throw away.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so let's start. Start with something expensive. So I had a very expensive Canon SLR camera with a big lens, a flash, speed light, and a bag, and a big memory card. And it's something that, you know, I was just like holding on. It's like, I'm going to use it.
Yeah. We used to use it a fair amount.
Used to use it for before children.
And
used
before
to use it a lot.
iPhones.
Yes, before iPhones. We used to use it a lot because, you know, you had to carry that. And then, you know, with children and, you know, going out for the day with them, it wasn't practical to carry things and carry a massive camera bag with a really heavy camera. So, you know, and as the lenses in phones have and quality have just, you know, infinitely just grow, getting exponentially better every year, you know, most of the time we just take pictures on the iPhone.
Yeah.
It's as simple as that.
So it's been
nice,
sitting in the cupboard.
So I probably haven't used it for 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
And I thought, it's time.
Yeah.
It's time. I really wanted to keep it. And I may buy another camera at some point, a smaller compact one.
Yeah.
But for the moment, it's gone. It's gone to the eBay in the sky.
Yeah.
So I got £600 for that camera and the whole bundle. I actually sold it in a couple of separate bundles because it's better if you do that, because, you know, you can sell, say, the body only of an SLR.
Yeah.
And then you can sell the lens separately.
Because people like to have different lenses and cameras, don't they?
So, exactly.
But check it out, because sometimes things sell better as bundles and sometimes they sell better in parts and you'll make more money. But you can do your research, can't you?
Yes, definitely research. So research sold listings, that's what you want to do.
Mm-hmm.
Then the next thing is broken computers. Now, most of you, when you have a broken computer, what do you do with it? I bet you just throw it in the bin. Well, guess what? It's worth money.
Yeah.
I know, you'd never know that. So yeah, we have, so whenever one of our computers breaks, our children break it. Yes, we have a child every time something crashes, he hits the computer, which is not great.
That killed one.
It died. Whenever we have a broken computer, we sell it on eBay and we put in the brackets four parts.
Yeah, so it's really clear. Very clear. This is a working computer. Yeah.
And loads of people sell computers for parts. Mm-hmm. And then we put in the description as to what exactly was wrong with it. Because in this case, so it was a Lenovo Yoga laptop. And in this case, it would turn on, occasionally crash, and then the screen would go weird with kind of a halo around it. Mm. And we sold that for £80.
Mm.
Okay. So, you know, that would have ended up in the bin otherwise.
I think it had only cost 350 new as well. So it wasn't an expensive one.
Yeah. Now, in the past, just so you're aware of the difference, Macs go for a lot of money for parts. So we sold a Mac Mini, which is just like a box like this. So it doesn't have a screen, doesn't have a keyboard. It's just, you know, just a box with a processor in it. And we sold that for around £200.
Mm.
So they really, you know, you get a lot of money for those, which is good. And we had an iPad Mini. So about this big.
Not so mini.
which is quite large now.
Yeah, the first generations were really big.
And, you know, we'd had that for a long time. And basically our kids were using it for gaming.
Yeah.
And then they moved to a newer iPad Mini some time ago. And it was just still sitting in the cupboard.
Yeah.
And we thought, let's sell it. So that we got £40 for.
Mm.
So that was quite old. And then we sold a double camp bed that we had, which was in the garage, really heavy.
George decided he really, really didn't want to go camping.
Yeah, we're fine. I'm more a hotel guy.
Yeah.
Take me to a hotel. Give me a nice shower.
I quite like to go camping. But anyway.
I just find it uncomfortable.
It was sitting in the garage, so I thought, no.
It was big, you know. Yeah. It was quite a chunky, heavy thing.
Mm.
So we sold that, £55. I had an office swivel chair. Had a spare one, so we sold that for £15.
Yeah.
A kids bean bag, £10.
Yeah.
Now, this one's quite interesting. So, an Xbox 360. So not the latest model.
It's quite an old system. Yeah.
Now we bought one a while ago as a bundle, and we were lucky enough to get it for £12.50 with a load of stuff.
Yeah, I'm quite good at eBay.
She was very good at that. Mm. And we sold only the Xbox, not all the stuff, for £20.
Yeah.
Now we did. This wasn't.
We ended up with two, didn't we? Because I bought a couple of different bundles, and they happened to end, and I ended up with both of them. So, oh, okay then.
Yeah, it was an accident.
Yeah, but we wanted the games.
Yes.
For the, you know, so we sold off what we didn't need, basically.
Yeah. So we actually made a little bit of money. We weren't intending to, but it just happened. What doesn't sell well? Well, Xbox 360 games don't sell very well.
No, we tried that.
They tend to go for like 99p.
Yeah, which with the postage, and it's just not worth the effort. It's not worth it.
So we did sell a couple we sold like two together for £2. But,
yeah, but again, it's
barely worth your time.
Yeah, it's not worth the hassle really. Yeah. And quite often, you know, we're not taking into account eBay fees and PayPal fees and postage fees. It can, you know, not even take into account walking to the post office. Exactly. It's just not worth it.
My time is definitely worth more than that.
Yes.
Or your time, because you
yeah, I'm the one that does it.
To the post office. so yeah, there's so much you can sell. But just in terms of a couple of tips for you.
Mm.
What we've found over the years is the best time to end an auction on eBay is at the weekend.
Yeah. So end people
it
look
on a Saturday or a Sunday, and don't end it like early in the morning because not everybody's up.
Yeah. It's like Sunday 3 or 4 o'clock in the afternoon is pretty good because it gives people a chance to look over the weekend as well.
Definitely.
But that's only if you're doing sort of a time listing. Sometimes it can be work to just list something kind of for like 30 days. It depends on what it is.
Yeah. Definitely. The other thing is, so for things you sell in the, what we found is the things you sell in the post, eBay's good.
Yeah.
But when it comes to big things, bulky things to collect,
we found very heavy, cheap things.
Yes, very, that's true. Like, you know, if you had, the beanbag, for example.
Not going to post that, are you?
Don't want to post that. It's going to cost you a fortune to post it. So those things are much better on Facebook Marketplace.
Yeah.
And you can list them for free. Now the only issues we found is that people on Facebook Marketplace really mess you around. So they'll go, is it available? And you go, yes. And then you don't hear back from them again.
Yeah.
So that happens quite a lot. Or they'll arrange to come round and then they don't turn up.
Yeah.
So they're a bit annoying.
There's no feedback system on Facebook Marketplace. That's the problem with eBay. you can kind of say these people messed me around as feedback. So people tend to be pretty good. If you sell something on eBay, even if it's cash on delivery, they will generally turn up and not mess you around. So that's an advantage of using eBay, but obviously it's going to cost you some money.
So that's how we made £1,000 on one day at the weekend.
Yeah, we had everything finishing on a Sunday.
Go! Money! Yeah. Ka-ching! Yeah. So you can do that too. If you need to raise £1,000 quickly, just look around your house, look in the loft, look everywhere, collect it all together, and you'd be surprised how much it is all worth.
Yeah.
So thanks for listening. Please subscribe, share it with your friends, and we'll see you next week.
Bye.
Bye.